first went into evangelistic work 12 years ago. My wife was there, my son, and what little I have ever done, and I emphasize the word little when it comes to doing for Jesus. I do not want to paint a black picture, but I do want to be honest with you. For 2 years, I averaged $35 a week. I fed my family. I bought our clothes. Never to drive a car. Now I know that's not appetizing to this materialistic age today, I realize this. But do you know that many of the college kids that are rebelling, many of them are not from the slums or the scums. They are from affluent Paris, and they've become sick of carpet and chandeliers, big houses, fine cars, and more money and more money. With a hypocritical heart and nature that's alive all the way around. For 2 years, I had to pray every revival that came in. I had to pray them down. And then after I got there, I had to pray the glory down. There's really no other way. Young man, you can go to these Bible schools and be fine, qualitative gentlemen spoke about this afternoon or morning until you're blue in the face and got a string of degrees behind your name that long and still be the biggest spiritual deadhead that ever lived. Get the glory and the anointing and the power of God. You're talking against education? Mercy, no. God is actually the author of knowledge and education. But don't think it'll take the place of the Spirit and the move of God and the Holy Ghost. Hard, yes I do. I don't play church. My cousin Jerry Lee Lewis. We were raised together like brothers. I've heard him speak in other tongues. He sold over 15 million records. Just about every record that he puts out today, it goes to the top 10 in the C&W field. I saw 4 gold records hanging on his new home or house in Louisiana just a few days ago, each signifying $1 million worth of sales. Money rolling in at such a rate. When he first started, he and Elvis Presley were neck and neck for the rock and roll crown. They put out the song, I believe it was Blue Suede Shoes or Don't Be Cruel, I think that was the name of it. Jerry Lee's version went over in sales a little bit of Mr. Presley. He was given the silver record in 57 for being the hottest performer in his line for that respected year. Turned his back on God. Turned his back on preaching the gospel. Turned his back on Jesus Christ and the call of God for his heart. One Sunday, I was at my home church preaching a meeting. We had a dinner on the ground and Jerry Lee's dad drove up in a big brand new Cadillac. In those days, Jerry Lee was averaging $2,500 a day.
Now, that's not a lot of money now to a lot of people. It's a lot to me, some of you. But everything was going his way. Every song a hit. Gold records coming his way. You'll tell that reporter. God told me to preach. And I ought to be a preacher. And I'm sorry for the one man. I'm sorry for the one man.
Yeah. Get it. Thank you. me, baby. Now ride 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 me, baby.
Oh, girl, you think you slick? Let me see you pop this shit.
That ass.
Thank you.
heat the roots of a tree and not heat the tree.
Racine. Girl, is that Don't you? Baby, don't you? stacks about four times, and each time I was turned down. I kept trying, Finally, they took me in.
We need funky soul.